for some reason, a face always accompanies that statement. I moved.
No.
I moved. I moved. I moved. I moved. I moved. We actually have footage of it.
Goodness.
Yep, that happened. All of it. Here's what moving would be if it was an animal. Here's what moving would be if it was a food. Here's what moving would be if it was a person. Because I had to call 8 companies, moving companies. They had phones from like the 18th century when they didn't exist. That's how bad the connection was. They had non-existent phones. Basically what they had was a tin can and a piece of string that attached to somebody else's phone. I was like, hello, can I get an estimate for moving? They had a lot of questions before I could actually get a quote. Hello, can I please get a quote for moving to Los Angeles from Chicago? Sure thing! What's your experience been with our company? Great, I just called you, thanks. Excellent, thank you ma'am for answering that question. Well, how did you hear about us? Online. So, what was your experience when you went online? Ma'am. Bye! And that's what it sounds like to turn a phone off. What is it like moving from Chicago to Los Angeles and driving for 3 consecutive days? I'm hungry. Yes, I'm so excited. We're really conquering our lives. I'm tired. There's still cornfields everywhere. And 8 hours in, darkness sets in. So you enter this abyss and you might as well be driving in the ocean. It's not like, oh cute, seashells and Ariel. It's like, ugh, like creepy fish that have no eyes and like little worms hanging from their heads and they're like, eh, come here. The little fish comes and then they like, ugh, they eat the little fish. You're driving to more darkness, more doom. You're already driven for 8 hours and you're exhausted, so you're driving like this and your neck is cramping up and you think you're gonna die and you're about to die. And then you drive off the road into an inn and it's all booked up because all the other drivers were like, we're exhausted, we're driving in the middle of an ocean, we don't know what we're doing either. We don't wanna die and kill ourselves on this road highway thing. Blah. So you drive around to other little inns until you find one because you didn't make a reservation. You could see like the vultures circling your car. We drove past Las Vegas. I don't know why anyone ever wants to visit Las Vegas. It's like a shiny tampon. Maybe it's a pretty container casing that may be colored, but inside there's a wad of cotton waiting to enter. Well, that's another video. I saw probably 23 signs from Las Vegas onward advertising the best alien jerky around. Why is that a marketing technique? Why is alien jerky a thing? It's not enough to see an alien, but you gotta eat one too. Gib gab, this is so much fun.
Gib gab, I don't get good lighting right here. You have these beautiful lights on you, perfectly evenly lit. I'm sitting in the background on the couch with no pants on.
It's very hot in California. Moving in with a guy is just like moving in with yourself, except there's another self in the room that breathes the same air and sometimes has extra dirty dishes for you to wash.
I do the dishes too.
He does the dishes too. Tyler sits in that same corner every day, which is convenient because instead of a decorative pillow, I have a decorative boyfriend chilling on my couch. DIY. If you want to see an apartment tour of any of the things behind me, and there's a hallway, and there's a kitchen, there's a bathroom, you want to see where I poop and pee, let me know and I'll give you that tour.
TMI.
With me, you get the raw and exposed version. You get the poopy version. You also get jazz hands. by myself, floating in a room.